Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Sandeep Gautte. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel English Guru for All. In this video lesson, we are going to discuss about physical barriers to communication. Friends, everybody knows that communication is a very important part in human life. And this particular video lesson is talking about, or we are going to discuss, how different barriers may block the communication process. Now let us discuss one by one, but the title is what everybody knows, that is on the screen, physical barriers to communication. Please listen to me carefully, and if you have any doubt, any problem, you can comment in the comment box. Now let us start with this, what is given there. Now friends, first, meaning of communication is given there. What is communication? Communication is an integral part of human life. And everybody knows that without communication, no one can live. If this is the case, so we have to take this one seriously. Communication is very important for everyone. And without communication, no one can live at all. So communication is very important for us. And we fulfill each other's needs with the help of communication. So what is the basic function of communication? To understand each other, right? So if this part is so much important for our life, and without it we cannot live, this is the inseparable part of human life, then we have to take it seriously, and we must have effective communication. Communication, different means can be used for communication. That is the different part. Already I uploaded some videos related to this, really, like verbal communication, non-verbal communication, or different parts can be used for that. So two definitions are given on the screen, dear friends, dear students. One is of Charles Sumner and second one is of Fred Gimmer. So Charles Sumner is saying what? Communication is an exchange of facts, ideas, opinions or emotions by two or more persons. Now here you need to understand first, what is communication? This is nothing but an exchange. Exchange between what? Two or more persons. And what are we going to exchange? That is nothing but what? There are different parts. One is facts, second one is ideas, third one is opinions, and fourth one is what? Emotions. So here, you need to understand some parts. So here, communication is nothing but sharing. Sharing of what? Facts, ideas, opinions, emotions. And minimum two persons are needed for the communication process. Out of them, one is speaker and another one is listener. But they can change this role also. Right? So here, Charles Sumner has given this particular definition, or that is the meaning of communication. Now, Fred G. Meyer is saying what? That communication is the intercourse by words, letters or messages. Now here you need to understand again what is given there. That is, communication is intercourse, means what? That is nothing but what? Exchange or sharing. What do we share? Words, letters or messages also. Now words and letters are, you can say what? They are nothing but the medium to construct the message. And whatever message you are going to construct, that message will be conveyed to your listeners with the help of different, you can say, channels. Now this is the meaning of communication. Before explaining physical barrier, I explain this one over here. Now let us talk about what? Physical barrier, what is there? Now, what is meant by barrier to communication? So barriers are nothing but the impediments that hamper the communication process. Or you can say what? Impediments that hamper the communication process are termed as barriers to communication. Dear friends, what is the meaning of impediments over here? Nothing but blocks, right? Some kind of problems, easy to understand. Barrier means what? Nothing but what? Problems. Or you can say impediment means what? Blocks. So I'm talking about problems in the communication process. So it is very easy to understand. Barrier is nothing but a problem that may block the communication process. Means what word I used over here for that? That is impediments. So impediments that hamper the communication process are termed as barriers to communication. And these barriers block effective communication and there cannot be proper give and take of ideas. Means what? Message cannot be given, or you can say conveyed properly. It may be blocked. Now both may have, you can say, these problems. Means I mean to say speaker as well as listener. So technical terms are there, sender and receiver. Now these barriers can be external as well as internal. Now here you need to understand what is the meaning of external and what is the meaning of internal. External means what? Surrounding of the speaker and the listener, right? And internal means related to the physicality or the body of the sender and the receiver. Now let us discuss one by one. I am sure that over here you understood the meaning of barrier to communication. What is that? The blocks. There are certain problems that may block the communication process, that may hamper the communication process, and such are nothing but what? Barriers to communication. Let us discuss one by one different barriers. We are talking over here about physical barrier. Now there is one diagram, friends. Please see that diagram. What is the diagram over there? In this diagram, types of physical barrier are given. One is a physiological or biological barrier, and second one is what? Environmental barrier. Here you should get it clear, crystal clear. There are two types of physical barrier. One is what is that? Physiological. It is also called as biological, and this is also called as internal barrier. Already I explained that one. What I mean to say, some barriers, or these barriers may be internal. Internal means related to your physiology, means your body. There may be certain problems over there also. And second one is environmental barrier, that is external. What is the meaning of external? That is nothing but what? Surrounding of the speaker and the listener, or you can say the surrounding of the sender and the receiver. Now these are the two types. Now let us talk about these two types one by one. Now, first one is physical or biological barrier. Now it is also called as internal barrier. Already I told you that related to physicality of the speaker or maybe the listener. Now this is the result of, this kind of barrier is the result of what? Sensory dysfunction. Means what? Sensory dysfunction means what? Related to speaking, hearing, seeing. All these are the fundamental parts of effective communication, everybody knows. Now what are the different examples of this? Illegible handwriting means that is not clear, and it is the problem because of what? Your physicality. Second one is pronunciation problem. If you are pronunciation problem, if you are not able to pronounce the words properly, then even this is the physiological, or you can say biological barrier. It is also called as internal barrier. Deafness is also there. Suppose you are not able to hear and there is a problem, listening problem is there, then that is also physiological, or you can say biological barrier. All these are different barriers that may hamper the communication process. Now I am sure that the concept of physiological or biological barrier is clear over here. I give the examples over here and also the meaning of this particular barrier. I am sure that now you may be able to identify different physiological, or you can say what, biological barrier to communication. I request you all to identify such barriers and make the list of such barriers to communication. Now we are going to discuss next one, environmental barrier. What does it mean? What is the meaning of environmental barrier? It is also called as external barrier. External means surrounding. Now second point, see the second point what is given there. Disturbances in the communication process can be occurred due to physical surrounding and natural features of the world. And examples are given there. One is sudden rain, traffic noise, loud music, distance, pure ventilation. Sorry, what is given there? Poor ventilation. And here you need to understand. So disturbances means what? Communication process can be stopped because of the physical surrounding and the natural features of the world. Now example, you can take what? Sudden rain. I would like to explain this a little bit more. Suppose you are delivering a speech in the open ground, you are on the stage, and so many audience, you can say spectators are there, they are listening to you carefully, and suddenly the rain starts. What will happen? Is it possible for you to continue with your communication? No. It means that is the environmental barrier. Your communication process is stopped because of sudden rain. Suppose there is loud music and you are trying to communicate with someone and that music is increasing, you can say, and in that case, what is the problem? There cannot be proper communication between the sender and the, you can say, what, a receiver. In that case, even the communication process can be stopped. So that is called what? Environmental barrier. Dear friends, I am sure that at least here two concepts are clear. One is what? What is meant by physical barrier? And second one is what? What is the meaning of barrier? So barriers are nothing but the problems that may affect the communication process. Now the most important part I am going to discuss now. There are four distractions in physical barrier. The most important, already we talked about or even we discussed what, two types over there, physiological or biological barrier, that is called internal barrier, and second one is what, that is environmental barrier, that is also called as external barrier. Now the first distraction, that is the competing stimulus. What is that stimulus? I explain that one. In this case, the disturbances may be in the form of another conversation going on within hearing distance, loud music and traffic noise. So this is the part of what, dear friends? This is under what? Environmental barrier. Already I explained this part there. So suppose there is a problem. Suppose already I told you that there, suppose there is a loud music, hearing distance. So that is related to what? Audibility. Suppose you are not able to listen to the person. In that case, that is the hearing distance. So this is what, this is the first distraction in the physical barrier, that is the competing stimulus. We are going to see the next one now. What is that? Environmental stress. What is that? Environmental stress. So that is, suppose there is the factors like humidity, poor ventilation, strong glare, in the, that may disturb your smooth communication. Suppose there is poor ventilation, what will be the problem? Suffocation will be there and you may not concentrate on your communication or in your communication process. In this way, environmental stress can also stop, or you can say what, can also hamper your communication process. And just because of all these factors, there cannot be effective communication. Now let us discuss the third distraction. Subjective stress. Subjective means again related to internal. Internal means what? Physiological barrier. What is that? Sleeplessness, ill health, mood variations, etc. may disturb listening and interpreting means understanding the message. Suppose there is the lecture early in the morning at 8:30 in your college and you did not sleep for the whole night just because of your studies. Hope so. And in the morning you are there in the college and you are attending the lecture and you are feeling sleepy. What will be the problem? You may not concentrate on what? Listening to your teacher. And if you are not able to listen to your teacher properly, then you cannot interpret that message properly. You cannot understand. It means subjective stress can be there. So all these are the different problems, the different distractions are there. Now we are going to discuss the fourth one, and what is that? Ignorance about the medium. Ignorance about the medium. The use of a medium with which the receiver not familiar may become a barrier in understanding. For example, inability to read maps, graphs and charts. Suppose you are using such medium, here you need to understand what is the meaning of medium, friends. Medium and channel both are two different terms. Sometimes many students get confused because of these terms. Channel is what? Channel means what you use to convey the message to your receiver. And what is the meaning of, what is the meaning of medium? Medium means what we use to, or what you use to construct the message. Means words are there, different symbols are there, signs are there, charts are there. So if you are using, we are talking about that part. Suppose your receiver is not able to read and you are giving that particular message, you can say, suppose you are writing something and your receiver is not able to understand that one. It means what? You are ignoring the medium. So you are not considering your, you can say, what, receiver. Dear friends, in this way I explain physical barrier to communication in this video lesson. I am sure that it will be useful for you, and I explain even the types of you can say physical barriers to communication. I am going to shoot some videos related to more barriers to communication, and it will be useful for everyone. Thank you so much, and please I request you all to subscribe my channel, like and share the video as well as the channel details. Thank you so much.